This video will run through the remaining part of the example. So we started out talking about the fact that the mat is the paper area around the picture between that and the frame. It has a uniform width, so the distance all the way around, and I'm just drawing that in with little green lines here, we could let that be X, which is what I have written right here. Let X be the width of the mat. And by doing that, we can come up with dimensions for the inner picture here. So this section in here where the actual picture would go. The original dimensions were 45 by 30, but if I take a look at just the green picture area from here to here, so that length would be the 45, but we're going to take off an X for this part and another X for this part. So I'm taking away two X's. So the length of our picture is 45, take away two X. The width, very similarly, is going to be 30 because the whole width here is 30, but I'm going to take it back by two groups of X, an X here and an X here. So altogether, the new width of the picture is 30, take away 2X. So that's really what our premise is here. I know that the area of my picture is going to be a 30 minus 2X, and that has to multiply, length times width, the 45 minus 2X. And it doesn't matter which order that you multiply those two dimensions by. It could be width times length. That's going to give you the same as length times width. Now, we also talked about the area overall being this 1350, and we said the area of the mat should equal the area of the picture. So what that means is we need to take that 1350 and cut it in half, divide by 2, and that gives us 675, and that will be the area of the picture. So that 675 can fit in right here. Okay, now I don't have a zero here, so I can't just set my little factors equal to zero and solve, because that only works when I have a zero on that part, a zero on the left side of my, or on the right side of my equal sign, separate from the factors. So what I'm going to need to do here is actually expand and simplify. So we're going to multiply the 30 through the bracket and get our answers for that, and then we're going to take that minus 2x and hop through the bracket, multiply those two things by the minus 2x, and get our answer from there. So I'm going to have 675 left on that left side there. A 30 times 45 we know is 1350 from the work we did above. It's 1350. 2x times the 30, or 30 times minus 2x would be minus 6. Sorry. Somehow I'm moving this thing around. Minus 60x. The 2 times the 45, the two groups of 45 would be 90, so that's going to be a minus 90x. And then negative 2 times negative 2 would be positive 4, and then x times x is x squared. And then we're going to get everything to one side and set it equal to 0 on the other side. And I'm going to rewrite this in descending powers of x. So that gives us 4x squared, minus 150x when we combine the x terms. And then I have 1350. I'm going to subtract 675 from both sides here. 675. And for some reason, my cursor does not like to write the actual full numbers down there. There we go. And that is going to give us a plus 675 here. Now, I could try factoring this, common factoring, but you know what? I'm going to go right into, I think, the quadratic formula, because the numbers are going to be really big if I start multiplying to 4 times 675. There's actually nothing in common that I can take out. So quadratic formula says x equals negative b, so I'm going to have negative, and my b is negative 150, which will make that into a positive 150 in a moment, plus or minus the square root of b, which is negative 150. That needs to get squared, minus 4 times the a, which is the 4, times the c, which is the 675, all divided by 2a, 2 times 4. Okay, and I'm going to stop the video for a moment and put these things into my calculator so that I can get an answer. All right, so I let my calculator do some magic. Under the square root sign, the number here is, right here, is 11,700, and then I broke that into the two pieces where I have the positive, the add, the square root, and the minus the square root. And when I did, I got my two answers. One is a 32.27, one is a 5.23. Now, in terms of context for the question, we're talking about the width of the mat. Now, given that the picture itself, I'm just going to switch colors here, I'll just use black. The width of the picture itself is only 30 centimeters. Okay, so is it possible to have the mat be 32.27 centimeters wide? Yeah, not going to work. So this is an extraneous root. It's a root that does not make sense for the problem. So I'll just put does not make sense, because our mat, our value of x would have to be less than half of one of the dimensions, the smallest dimensions. It would have to be less than 15, because if one half, one part was 15 and the other part was 15, that would add up to 30. So it's got to be, your x has to be less than 15, but greater than 0. And that's called the domain for the problem. We're saying we can only look at these particular values of x. Beyond that, it doesn't make sense. Okay, so this does not make sense. And so what we have here is that, therefore, the mat has to have a width, or should have a width, of about 5.2 centimeters. Okay, and you should put a therefore statement with that. But in the sake of time, I'm going to leave that and move on to the example in the back. All right, so Dharma is selling an average of 30 necklaces per week at the beach for $6. $1.50 in materials is her cost to make each one. She's done a survey. For every 50 cent increase in price, she's going to lose 2 sales per week. And we're going to find out what she should charge to maximize her profit there. I'm just going to put on the screen here what we had figured out so far. Okay, so we have that revenue is the number of necklaces sold times the price they're sold for. So we started out with, so that's where I am right here, this equation. We started out with 30 necklaces being sold for $6 a piece. But then we were adjusting it. We knew that for every 50 cent increase in price, so we take the price of $6 and we're increasing it by groups of 50 cents, then the number sold, the 30, will decrease in groups of 2. So with this, we're really letting X, let X represent the number of 50 cent increases of price. Let X represent the number of 50 cent increases in price. Oh, I wish I could type or write better on this, but it's not so great in price. Okay, and from there, we know that the cost is the number of necklaces that she makes times the cost to make each one, and each one costs $1.50. The number of necklaces we already had up here as being 30 take away 2x. So that just got replaced with number of necklaces down here, which is 30 minus 2x. And then profit is just your revenue take away your cost. So what I have written here is what we have above for our revenue function, the 30 minus 2x, and then multiply by the 6 plus 0.5x, and we want to take away the cost. And the cost function is this one right here. I'm going to put the $1.50 first, just because that looks more normal to me, to how we would normally see that. We usually put the monomial before the binomial, and then we'll multiply through by that $1.50. All right, now if I expand through the brackets, so Bedmas says I have to multiply before I can do the subtract here. I'm going to multiply the first two brackets together. Three groups of six is 18, so that'll be 180. And then 0.5, a half of 30. So multiplying the 30 with the 0.5, I should have a plus 15x. And then we're going to have the minus 2 multiplying both terms. So minus 2 times minus positive 6 would be minus 12x. And then a minus 2 times 0.5, or a half of 2, would be negative 1x squared. Or negative x squared. All right, so I reached the end of the bracket. I'm done that first multiplication, and now we're going to take that negative 150 and have it hop through the bracket here. And when it does, we should have negative 4.5. I need my calculator just to double check my numbers here. 4.5 would just be 3 times 150. Add a zero to that. That should be 45. And then take away, that'll become a plus. A negative times a negative will be plus. 2 times 150 would be 3x. All right, now we're going to collect like terms. And I've got just a negative x squared, no other x squares to go with that. Now I'll look at the x terms. I have 15x's here, a minus 12x's here. That's 3x's, plus 3 more x's. That will equal plus 6x's. And then we have 180 take away 45. So 180 take away 40 would be 140. Take another 5 off of that. That should be a plus 135. Okay, now what I could do is try to factor this, or I can go directly into the quadratic formula. Except, what is it that I want to find? I want to find the maximum. So to find the maximum, this is a downward facing parabola. Y-intercept at 135. If I want my maximum, I'm thinking that I want the vertex. And to get the vertex, I could complete the square. So that's what I'm going to do with this. I'm going to complete the square. I'm going to common factor in the negative 1, my value of a, out of the x squared and the x term. And we leave the c term outside. And then I'm going to take half of 6, which is 3, and then square that, and I get 9. So 9 is what I want to add and subtract inside that bracket. So I'm going to add 9, and then subtract 9, and then I still have my plus 135 on the outside. And then we're going to multiply that negative 1 with the negative 9 to move it out of the bracket, which will make that a plus 9. So we have our negative x squared minus 6x, plus 9. And then the minus 1 times minus 9 becomes a plus 9. And then we still have the plus 135 here. Now I'm going to factor that trinomial, which we set up to be a perfect square. That should be x take away 3 all squared. Square root the first, square root the last, take the sign from the middle, and then all to the exponent of 2. And then we're going to collect like terms here. 135 plus 9, that could be 144 there. So our max or our vertex is at positive 3 and 144. So this is the x, and this is P for profit. So we're going to have 3 as our x value. The x is 3, and our P, our maximum profit, is the 144. So her maximum profit is $144, but it says what price should she charge to maximize the profit? Okay, so x is the 3. Now we know x represents the number of 50 cent increases in price, and we also know that the 6 plus 0.5x is the price that each one is sold for. So we want to know what price should she sell them for, what price should she charge. So 6 plus 0.5 times the x that maximizes, which is 3, will give us our correct answer for that. That should be $1.50 extra, so she should sell them for $7.50 to maximize her profit. Okay, hopefully that helps.